Art, what kind of an instrument is that that you're playing?
That's a flugelhorn.
I know it said so in our opening announcement, but I've often wondered why have you switched from the trumpet to this?
Well, because the sound is a little warmer, and playing in small clubs with a small group, I find that I can play this horn without using mutes. Because when you use mutes, you run into bad PA systems and sort of gets lost, messed up, sort of.
Have you used the flugelhorn long?
Well, I've been playing the flugelhorn exclusively for about 15 months now.
Mm-hmm. Had you used it much before that?
Well, yes, I use it. I alternated between the flugelhorn and the trumpet for about a year before I just switched to the flugelhorn.
Does the flugelhorn blend better with the guitar than the trumpet would?
I think it does, at least when I play it.
Yeah, for you it does.
For me, yeah. I like the sound better.
I also noticed that, quite obviously, there's no piano in the group.
Right.
Why is this?
For two reasons. The first and most important reason is that when you have a guitarist of the caliber of Jim Hall, you really don't need a piano. And there are only a few piano players around who would be able to play with Jim without being superficial. For instance, Tommy Flanagan, who was playing with Ella Fitzgerald.
Well, now, when you say that they would be superficial, or that when you have someone as good as Jim Hall, you don't need a piano, what function does the piano ordinarily perform that he makes superfluous in this group?
Well, you see, the piano performs the function of playing chords in back of the horn solo, for one thing. Mm-hmm. Also playing solos, which Jim plays chords behind the horn, and he plays his own solos. Also, the piano, the guitar, when played by a person of the caliber of Jim, can play like a horn, and we can do some things like two horns playing.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
So he's really doing the work of two men.
When you originally started the group, was this your idea?
Well, it was. The only idea that we had to start the group was to get four people together who played well and were sensitive to each other,
mm-hmm.
and just try to play in a way that we would be able to enjoy what we were doing. We felt if we did that, well, then other people would enjoy what we were doing also.
Most of your repertoire seems to be ballads and standards songs. Is this deliberate, or has it just worked out that way with you?
No, really, we look for tunes that are melodic, because that's what we like. Uh-huh. And as time goes by, where we add more so-called jazz tunes, but whatever we play is it's a jazz tune according to how you interpret it. And we, of course, we only play tunes that we like to play.
Do you discuss the tunes yourselves and decide on what ones you're going to do, or how do you pick them?
Well, we, you know, like if someone hears a tune that they like and they feel that we would like to play with them, we have a rehearsal.
Yeah.
And we try it a few different ways, and if it comes off of them, we wind up playing it.
Are there many that you discard?
Well, there are a few.
Yeah.
A few. You know, sometimes you just can't get anything going on a certain tune, not meaning that it's a bad tune, but it's just not the tune for us.
Doesn't fit with the way you feel or the way you approach music?
Right.
Yeah. What tunes did you have in mind to play for us for the rest of the show?
Well, we were going to do a tune by a young South American composer named Sergio Mihailovich called Some Time Ago, which we think is a very beautiful tune. And we were going to do one called My Kind of Love, which was made popular by Sarah Vaughan and Lee Wiley a few years ago. And also, we were going to do a tune that we feature our drummer, Walter Perkins, on. This is by Charlie Parker, called My Little Suede Shoes.
All right, let's go.
That's about it. So
all
we'll
right.
Start off with Some Time Ago.
Okay, thanks.